It's a far, far better thing I do than I have ever done before. A far better resting place I go to than I have ever known.
Is that a poem?
Mm-hmm. Something Spock was trying to tell me. My birthday.
You okay, Jim? How do you feel?
Welcome to the stage, your moderator for this evening. He's a rugby legend who took part in some of Scotland's greatest victories. Now better known as one of the BBC's most familiar faces on its news output as host on his drive time radio show and evening TV. Please welcome John Beattie.
And welcome to what will be a fantastic evening with an amazing man that I've managed to speak to behind the stage. Before we talk to him, let's have a look at what made him and makes him so brilliant. Here we go.
And now, ladies and gentlemen,
our host, William Shatner.
If he had to use my real name.
Parker, just tell me what you want, huh?
I want to close it down, Larry. You're gonna have to do your own dirty work now. Do you hear me? Bloodsucker.
Don't worry about it.
Into 37 languages.
Let it blow dry. I like a big beer. I like a clean.
Found the
Sometimes it looks like we're facing a knockout.
I think this is the greatest day of my entire life.
It's all right, buddy. One day you'll meet a girl. Something to ponder. Looked out the window, and I saw something going to the flame.
I run a charity horse show called the Priceline.com Hollywood Charity Horse Show. I've seen miracles happen with children and with veterans who've had ills of one kind or another that have been made better, if not well, by being on a horse.
Scottish welcome to the one, the only, the legend that is Mr. William Shatner.
Embarrassing. No, but it really is. I mean, that film was made 35 years ago, and then I come out. It's a bit discouraging. And it happens all the time. I handed the guy, British Airways guy, my credit card to come to Glasgow, and he looked at it. And then he looked at me, and he said, "Is that you?" And I said, he said, "My God, how time flies." So, you know, it's embarrassing. Let me put the film you just saw in its context so that it's kind of an interesting show business phenomena. We made a movie called The Movie, Star Trek The Movie. I imagine that somewhere in Paramount Studios, they had a meeting and Star Wars had hit. And the guys at the round the table, we gotta find something that is like Star Wars. What do we got? And I think the guy with the coffee, he said, "You know, remember that thing we had 6-7 years ago called Star Trek?" And they said, "Yes, Star Trek. It'll be better than Star Wars. Let's make a big movie of Star Trek. Let's get an A-list director." So they went for Robert Wise to make the movie. Robert Wise. I mean, he had just come off of big musicals, West Side Story, that kind of thing. Robert Wise. So now we're in the area of what I know to be true. So Robert Wise is approached to direct the movie. And he goes home at night and he says to Millicent, his wife, "Honey, you know, they've asked me to direct this film.